Welcome back, students. In this lecture, we are going to solve a few problems in the chapter of ultrasonics. Okay, so numerical problems are also important because there are in the semester question paper, there are numerical problems in every question of 5 marks each. Okay, so if there are 8 questions, there will be 8 numerical problems which you will need to solve. And it's very simple, you can very easily gain marks through these numerical problems. So do not miss out on the numerical problems which are there in your question paper. So we will be solving a few problems related to the formulas which we have studied in this chapter of ultrasonics. So the first problem, calculate the natural frequency of an iron rod of length 8 cm and comment on whether it can be used to generate ultrasonic waves using magnetostriction oscillator given density of iron and Young's modulus of iron. So given these things, we are told to find out whether this iron rod which is given to us of 8 cm, can we use this iron rod to generate ultrasonic waves or not? Now, in this such type of problems, whether a rod can be used or not, how do we determine it? If the natural frequency of the rod is more than 20,000 Hz, okay, then we conclude that the rod can be used to generate ultrasonic waves. If the natural frequency of the rod is less than 20,000, we say that the rod cannot be used to generate ultrasonic waves. So, the entire question therefore is to calculate the natural frequency of the rod. So, the formula for natural frequency, Fn, we have seen it while discussing the lectures. So, Fn is 1 upon 2L root of Y upon rho. Now, here L is the length of the rod, y is the Young's modulus of the rod, and rho is the density of the rod. So all these values are given to us in this problem. We just have to substitute and calculate Fn and then verify whether Fn is greater than 20,000 or less than 20,000, because remember, ultrasonic waves, the starting frequency is 20,000. So anything above 20,000 is ultrasonic. So let's calculate the natural frequency then using this formula. So it will be 1 upon 2 into length is given to us as 8 centimeters. Remember, centimeters is these other things which are given to us are in SI units. These are all SI units, whereas centimeter is not an SI unit, it is a CGS unit. So, we have to, whenever you are solving a problem, we have to solve it in a common set of units. There is no hard and fast rule that you have to solve it in SI units. You can solve it in CGS units also, but you have to be careful that whatever quantities are coming in the formula, they all have to be in the same set of units, either CGS or SI. So if you solve the problem in CGS units, the answer also which you will get will be in CGS units. If you solve the problem with all the quantities in SI units, the answer will also be in SI units. So please keep these things in mind when you are solving a problem. So be careful that all the quantities are in the same set of units. So length, here already two quantities are in SI, other one is in CGS, so it will be better to convert the single quantity into SI system. So 8 centimeters. So to convert 8 centimeters into meters, so we have to multiply it into 10 raised to minus 2. 1 centimeter is 10 raised to minus 2 meters. So that's the conversion factor. Okay. Then into root of Young's modulus is given as this value here, 11.5 into 10 raised to 10 raised to plus 10. Divided by the density is given here, 7.8 into 10 raised to 3. So if you calculate this, what will the value come out to be? So the value comes out to be 23,998. You can do this on a calculator. Part something is there, but let us for the moment not consider that. So 23,998 Hz is the value of Fm which comes up. Now if you see, this value is greater than 20,000. So we comment over here, since Fn is greater than 20,000 Hz, the rod can be used to generate ultrasonic waves. Okay, So very simple problem. So you just calculate the natural frequency and then check whether it is greater than 20,000. Now suppose the answer had come out to be less than 20,000, then we would have said since FN is less than 20,000, the rod cannot be used to generate ultrasonic waves. Okay, we have another similar type of problem here. So what's the problem? Ultrasonic waves are to be produced by a magnetostriction oscillator using either an iron or nickel rod of the same length. So we have given here two rods. One is iron, one is nickel. Both the rods are of the same length, that is 10 centimeters. Now the question is, which one is suitable for the production of ultrasonic waves? Justify your answer. And the densities of iron and the densities of nickel rod and the Young's modulus of iron and nickel rod are given to us. So again, by the same logic we go, we calculate the natural frequency of the iron rod. We also calculate the natural frequency of the nickel rod. And then we see whether these values of natural frequency are greater than 20,000 or less than 20,000. If the values come greater than 20,000, we say that yes, this rod can be used or this rod cannot be used. Okay, so that's how we determine. So let's solve this problem. So again, we start with for. So let's do it as two separate parts. So let's for iron rod, the formula for natural frequency is same whether it's iron or nickel rod. Only the values we will substitute are different. So Fn is 1 upon 2L root of y by rho. Now we put the values there. So 1 upon 2 into the length is same, so 10 centimeters. So again, you convert this into meters by multiplying by 10 raised to minus 2. So into root of for iron, Young's modulus is 11.5 into 10 raised to 10 divided by density of iron is 7.8 into 10 raised to 3, and this answer comes out to, the answer is 19198 hertz. Now you see this answer is less than 20,000 hertz. Okay, so we are going to comment over here, since Fn is less than 20,000, rod cannot be used. Now let's do the same thing for the nickel rod also and check. The formula for natural frequency is same. Fn is 1 upon 2L root of y upon rho. In this case, length is also again 10 centimeters. So into 10 raised to minus 2 into root of, what's the Young's modulus of nickel? Young's modulus of nickel is here, 20.7 into 10 raised to 10 divided by density of nickel is here, 8.9 into 10 raised to 3. Now this answer will come out to be 24113 hertz. Now you see this value is greater than 20,000. So we write over here, since Fn is greater than 20,000 hertz, the rod can be used to generate ultrasonic waves. Okay, so we can see therefore in this example, iron rod cannot be used, whereas nickel rod can be used. Now you may have problems wherein sometimes both the rod Fn comes out to be less than 20,000. Then what is the command you will write? That both the rods cannot be used. And sometimes the answer may come out that Fn for both the rods is more than 20,000. Then you have to just say both the rods can be used. So all the possible combinations are there. Either one rod can be used, other rod cannot be used, or both the rods can be used, or both the rods cannot be used. Okay? So you can get any problems based on the different types of combinations. So the next problem is calculate the velocity of ultrasonic waves in a liquid used in an acoustic diffraction grating using the following data. So wavelength of light is given to us, 6000 angstrom unit. Frequency of the ultrasonic transducer is given to us is 1 megahertz. And angle of diffraction of for second order maxima is given to us as 5 degrees 36 minutes. Now, we are required to calculate the velocity of ultrasonic waves. So, this was from the last part of the chapter. It's an acoustic diffraction grating experiment. Rewind, we have to find the velocity of ultrasonic waves. Okay, so what's the formula? Now, to find the velocity, first we need to know the wavelength of the ultrasonic waves, lambda u. So, we have to first going to calculate the value of lambda u, that is the wavelength of ultrasonic waves. Then using the value of lambda u, we are going to calculate the velocity of ultrasonic waves. So, first of all, what is the formula for lambda u? Lambda u was equal to 2n lambda upon sine theta. Okay, so this is equal to then, now, what is the order? Order of the wave maximum is the second order. So n is equal to 2. So 2 into 2 into lambda. Here lambda is the wavelength of light which is used. So it's given as 6000 angstrom unit. The angstrom unit is not an SI unit. So we need to convert it into meters. So 6000 into 10 raised to minus 10. That's the conversion factor for angstrom units to meters divided by sine of 5 degrees 36 minutes. Okay, so this answer will now 5 degrees 36 minutes on the calculator. There is an option for degrees and minutes button is there. Okay, check it out. You can directly see that the calculator is in degrees mode, and then you will enter this formula, then press the sign, and then press 5, and then press the degrees button, degrees, minutes, seconds button. There's a button on a calculator like this, okay? This way, then this way, and then this way. Okay, so this first is degree, then minutes, then seconds. So this button you can locate on a calculator. So once you press 5, you press this button once, then you type 36 and again press the same button. So on your display of the calculator, it will come as 5 0 36 0. So on the display it might not display it as minutes, but remember the calculator understands that the first number is in degrees, second number is in the minutes, and the third number, if there is, will be in seconds. So if there was a third number, let us say 45 seconds, then how do you enter it? So 5, then this button, 36, then the same button again, and then 45, and then the same button again. So you can enter values in degrees, minutes, seconds on the calculator using this degrees, minutes, seconds button. So you can calculate this, and the answer after you do this calculation will come. So this answer comes out to be 2.46 into 10 raised to minus 5 meters. Remember, because we have solved this problem in SI units, the wavelength value also comes out in SI units, which is in meters. Now using this wavelength value lambda u, we have to now calculate the velocity. Okay, velocity formula is v is equal to lambda u into f. So lambda u is 2.46 into 10 raised to power minus 5, and the frequency of the ultrasonic waves, which is given to us here, it's the frequency of the ultrasonic transducer, 1 megahertz. So which is 1 into 10 raised to 6. Mega stands for 10 raised to 6. So 1 megahertz is 1 into 10 raised to 6 hertz. So this answer comes out to be 24.59 or 24.6 error. Okay, meters per second. So this is the velocity of ultrasonic waves in that liquid. So we have calculated the wavelength first. This was the wavelength, and then using the wavelength, we have calculated the velocity of ultrasonic waves. So these are the possible types of questions you can get based in this chapter. One is either using the natural frequency FN formula, and the other type of problems are based on the acoustic diffraction grating. Let's do one more problem. So in this the problem is A piezoelectric crystal of thickness 3 mm produces ultrasonic waves of frequency 400 kHz. Calculate the thickness of this crystal to produce ultrasonic waves of frequency 500 kHz. So now this is a problem which is based on the piezoelectric effect. So there is a crystal of a thickness 3 mm, some type of some quartz, it could be any piezoelectric material. So its thickness is 3 mm. And this 3 millimeter thickness crystal produces ultrasonic waves of frequency 400 kHz. The question is, what should I change the thickness of the same crystal if I want to produce ultrasonic waves of frequency 500 kHz? So, for this, we are going to use the formula for the natural frequency of the crystal. So, what's the formula for that? Fn is equal to 1 upon 2t. Here it is 1 upon 2t. For a magnetostriction method, it is 1 upon 2l. L is the length. Here for a crystal, we talk in terms of its thickness. So 1 upon 2t. Other things remain the same. Y upon rho. Now, if you see in this formula, the frequency and thickness, Fn and t, are inversely proportional to each other. So I can write this equation in this format. Fn is proportional to 1 upon t. Because the other two things are constants over there. Y and rho are constant. For a given crystal, the density and the Young modulus remain a constant. If you change the crystal, they will change. But in this problem, we are talking about the same crystal. So, y and rho are constant. So, therefore, I can write this as Fn is proportional to 1 by t. Or I can write this as Fn is equal to some constant times 1 by t. Okay? So, using this as my general formula, I can further write that Fn1 is equal to C into 1 upon T1. This is for the first crystal, or for the first part of the problem. 1 refers to the first part where the thickness is 3 mm and the frequency is 400. And similarly, for another natural frequency, Fn2, I can write this as equal to the same constant C times 1 upon T2. So, using this main general equation, I have written two separate equations for two separate cases of thickness and frequency. Now, if I divide both these equations, if I divide this, so Fn1 upon Fn2, what will this be? This C will cancel out from there. It will be 1 upon T1 divided by 1 upon T2. So, they will invert each other. It will become T2 upon T1. Okay, so on dividing these two equations, I get this. So now all you have to do is put the values of Fn1, T1 and T2 and calculate the value of Fn2. So from this, what is Fn2? Fn2 will be equal to Fn1 into T1 by T2. You can rearrange these terms to calculate. So Fn2 goes on there, T2 will come down and this T1 will go this side. So it is Fn1 into T1 by T2. Now, what is Fn1? The first frequency which is given to us, this value. So, it is 400 into 10 raised to 3 because it is in kilohertz into T1. T1 is the first thickness which is given to us, 3 millimeters. So, 3 into 10 raised to power minus 3. I have converted millimeter into meters. So the 10 raised to minus 3 factor is to convert from millimeters to meters. And T2 is the thickness which is given in the second part of the problem. Okay, so yeah. So Fn2 value is already given to us. Fn2 value is 500 kHz. So let's put it over there. 500 kHz. 500 into 10 raised to 3. And T2 is what we have to calculate. So that is a slight mistake which I did. We are given the frequency Fn2, T2 we have to calculate. So let's not stop it and do it again. Let's continue it from this only. So T2, we have to calculate the value of T2. So from this, what will be T2 then? T2 will be equal to, T2 goes here, this comes down. This will be 400 into 10 raised to 3 divided by 500 into 10 raised to 3 into 3 into 10 raised to minus 3. And this answer, it comes out to be 2.4 into 10 raised to power minus 3, which I can write it as 2.4 millimeters. Okay, so this is my final answer. You can either give it as 2.2 into 10 raised to minus 3 meters, because we have solved it in SI units, the answer comes out in meters, but I have converted it into millimeters because the thickness was initially given to us also in millimeters. So you can see here, for a higher frequency you require a smaller thickness. Why? Because frequency and thickness are inversely proportional. So for 3 mm it produces 400 kHz. For a higher frequency you will require a thickness lesser than 3 mm. So that's what we get in the answer. We require a thickness of 2.4 millimeters. So hope you have understood all these problems. So with this we end this chapter on ultrasonics, including numerical problems. Thank you.